We are 48 hours away from the big game, and we are here with political analyst David Yonki. And the subject today is what else but the big game coming up on Sunday right here on WBRE-TV. David, it's great to have you back here on PA Live.
Happy to be here. Everybody's looking forward to it.
A lot of people don't think of politics when they think of the big game, but you're here to tie it in a little bit. Let's first talk about who you're rooting for.
Well, that's kind of like a 6 degrees of separation thing, because I'm a Green Bay Packer fan.
Okay.
And when the Vikings won the division, I had to root for the Vikings. However, when the Vikings lost and the Eagles beat them, I had to root for the Eagles, because Doug Peterson, the coach of the Eagles, was a backup quarterback for the Green Bay Packers.
Okay.
And it went to Brett Favre in the 1990s. And the last time the Eagles won a championship was in 1960. And guess who they beat? The Green Bay Packers.
Wow.
So 6 degrees of separation, Green Bay Packers. I'm rooting for the Eagles all the way.
All right. That's our, it comes full circle.
Exactly.
All right. So here's where politics come into play. There's a tradition where the president calls the game. Talk to us about that.
What the president does is there'll always be a phone call from the president, and then there'll be a subsequent White House visit. That started in 1969 when the Kansas City Chiefs won the Super Bowl, and President Nixon was, in fact, the first president to call the coach at the time, Hank Stram, and congratulate him on the game.
Oh, that's pretty neat. Do you think the tradition will
continue this year? Oh, of course. Yeah, they're going to keep on doing it. Yeah, definitely.
All right, wonderful. All right, so was there ever a time when a president was a standout football player?
Oh, yeah. Gerald Ford was probably one of the biggest and most incredible, best athletes we ever had as a president. In 1935, he was an All-American. Teddy Roosevelt actually mandated the forward pass. And Richard Nixon would call Coach Shula up of the Miami Dolphins in 1972 in the middle of the night and give him plays to put in the game.
Really?
I don't think Shula ever did it, but he was polite to him, and he was surprised that the president called at 1:30 in the morning.
President Nixon. Do you think President Trump is calling anyone at 1:30 in the morning with football plays these days?
He will tweet them, not call.
He will tweet them. Times have changed. And speaking of changing times, how have you seen the Super Bowl change year to year?
Well, it's become a national holiday. When the Super Bowl first started in 1967-68, it was one of those things where two networks actually covered it. The Los Angeles Coliseum wasn't really filled to capacity, so it's become a national holiday, and it is one of the things that makes America just a beautiful place to live.
I know. Maybe we can get the next day off. What do you think?
I think it should be a national holiday. I really do.
The next day, so everybody can recoup, right?
Exactly, right.
All right. And David Yonki from the LULAC Political Letter. If folks want to check you out online, how can they do so?
LULACPoliticalBlogspot.com.
All right, wonderful. Find him online. You can read all about his writings on politics and other things. David Yonki, as always, thank you so much for joining us.
Happy to be here. Thank you.
All right, here's Dave.